Hello and welcome to Behind the Boss, the interview series where we get to know the human behind the title. I'm your host, Katie Bavoso from The Channel Company. Get ready to rock because my guest today is the Senior Vice President of Global Channel Sales at 8x8, John Delosier, better known as JD. Welcome, JD.
Welcome, Katie. Thank you so much for having me.
It's so exciting to have the chance to get to know the real you. But first, let's talk a little bit about your title before we delve behind the curtain. You've spent more than 2 decades in the channel. Based on that experience and the events of the last 18 months especially, what are channel partners really in need of right now?
They're in need of this in a live setting. I mean, I have talked to so many different people. Everybody wants to get back out there. So I think the work from anywhere thing has changed things. But there's nothing like human interaction.
You've been Senior Vice President of Global Channel Sales at 8x8 for 3 years now. How would you describe your role in the company outside of your typical job description?
If I really could describe my role, it would be that I am the Chief Relationship Officer. You know, I got to get out there and evangelize and make sure the partners are taken care of and want to rock and roll with us.
JD, what is the biggest opportunity right now for your 8x8 channel partners?
We have pioneered something called XCaaS, Experience Communication as a Service. And this is really where contact center and voice meets in our platform. It's really revolutionizing the way we do business and certainly the way customers do business and the way partners are able to take it to them. So you will hear XCaaS a lot. We're excited about it. We can't wait to deliver it to the whole world.
You're inspired by a quote by Michael Dell that goes, "Try never to be the smartest person in a room. And if you are, I suggest you invite smarter people or find a different room." How does this impact the way you guide your team?
Yeah, we push, you know, I love that quote. We want to challenge ourselves. We want to keep the pedal down. We want to be around people that make us better. You know, my team, I only hire people that know more about their job than me. Because if I can do the job, I'll just do it, right? But if I hire people that know something I don't, that's how you get stronger.
JD, let's get to know you a bit more personally. You were born and raised in Ohio, and you are a self-proclaimed diehard Buckeye fan. As if I have to ask, based on what we see behind you, can you describe what you mean by diehard?
You know, when you're from Ohio, you're born bleeding scarlet. Doesn't matter if you're in Florida like me or California, it's Buckeye Nation. You see somebody with a Buckeye shirt on and you say, OH, I guarantee you they say IO back.
Can we try that right now?
OH.
IO.
That's it.
I'm an honorary Buckeye now. So JD, I've heard that you can play guitar and that when you were a kid, you actually wanted to grow up to become a rock star. So I have to ask, if you could pick any band in history to play with, who would it be and why?
I'm a diehard Van Halen fan. But there's no, you know, they have this guy named Eddie Van Halen who probably wasn't going to step aside for the, you know, farm kid from Ohio.
Well, JD, as you know, it's been a really difficult last year and a half for so many people, for so many reasons because of the pandemic. But now that we're coming out of that and can look back and reflect, what is one thing personally or professionally that living and working through the pandemic has taught you?
You know, the first thing that comes to mind is just the will of the human spirit. I mean, you can make us bend, but you're not gonna make us break. And, you know, I just felt like that the community in our world rose up. The work from anywhere thing happened. It's here. Let's adjust. And now it's coming back. And so, you know, I don't think it'll ever be the same, though. I think that this will happen as we move forward.
My last question for you is, if you could go back in time and talk to your younger self, what advice would you give yourself?
I think I would tell young JD, you know, just take a breath. It's going to be okay. It's all going to work out. I have a friend, a mentor, that passed away a few years ago. He was in a hospital. And he said, there's not one person in this hospital right now that are thinking, you know what? Gosh darn it. I spent too much time with my family. I had too many children. I played too much golf. They're saying all the opposite things. And so I always think of that.
JD, thank you so much for taking the time and allowing us to get to know the real you. I know that I'm going to be cheering for you all year long from the mosh pit all the way up to the nosebleed seats.
I love it. And during college football season, don't forget, you made a commitment today. So we're going to hold you to it.
OH.
IO.
Thank you so much, JD. And thank you at home for watching. This has been another Behind the Boss. I'm Katie Bavoso. Take care.